right, so we're back with Elizabeth. Her hair is damp, so I like to apply hashtag my hair lube, a couple pumps to the hand here. She has a lot of hair, so I'll probably say a good 8 pumps there.
Like that's so. A lot of lube.
Yeah, so I'm gonna massage it throughout my hands like this. Massage it down her ends like this, where she needs it the most.
Yeah, mids and ends is definitely where I would concentrate putting the majority of the product. Any residual, then I'll come back and do a little bit at the top.
And the slippage is everything. You can see the shine instantly. So when you look at my hair lube, it's clear. So you don't have to worry about it staining your platinum blondes. And if you have hair as blonde as Nora, and you use those very yellow oil, oh my God, it literally stains your hair.
With time, a lot of my clients were coming back and I wouldn't understand why their hair got so brassy when I know with the toner it shouldn't do that. So I switched them over to a clear my hair lube and now their color stays the same. It's beautiful.
Look at that. So now we're gonna blow dry her hair with the hair lube in and then we're gonna start styling her hair. Look awesome, girl. All right, so you can see the blend, the coloration looks magnificent. Magnifique. All right, so we're gonna use my Defender Heat Protectant Spray, and we're gonna do almost like a beachy lived-in type of curl. I know I've done this before, but every time I do it, you guys will see it's different on every head. I'm gonna do a triangle. I'm gonna pick out a triangle section right here. Usually a section about this thick. Everybody's head is different, so just make sure that when you measure based on how dense or thick their hair is on the ends, because that's where your squiggle waves are gonna come in, and if their hair is too thick down here, it's gonna look really chunky and clumpy. Make sure you spray on both sides here so you protect the hair on both ends. And I like to over-direct the hair towards me because when you over-direct the hair when you curl it, when it lays down, it stretches out. It's gonna look more voluminous and blended. I'm gonna curl it away from her face, so don't flip it, curl it under. I go under, stretch the hair, and then as it gets down to the ends, I pull it straight. So now you get that nice squiggle. It looks loose and not too spirally. When you wrap it too close together, it becomes a spiral.
So it looks like a boingy curl.
Yeah, you want to look boingy.
Like a spring.
Just like that. My Defender is gonna save your life, you guys. So you get heat protection up to 450 degrees. I curl everything back away from the face until I reach the back of the parietal area. Don't rake through the curl yet. Wait until you go around her whole entire head before you start running your fingers and a brush through it because it's not gonna last. You have to let the hair cool down.
So when the hair is hot, it's still moldable. So you wanna kind of let it cool down so it locks into shape.
See, now that we're behind the parietal area, I'm gonna start curling some pieces towards me. When you have this mist, it aerates and lands on the hair very, very evenly. It has a polymer that wraps around the hair that creates a shield blocking it from getting burnt. It almost like inflates the hair to give it volume. It's like a cushion, like a pillow. Even when you feel it on your hands, it has a cushion feeling that makes the hair feel like a pillow. When I get to the top, I don't really like to curl the hair towards me because I don't want it to look like a spring that's conflictive. Only internally will I curl the hair towards me. It's almost creating that internal confliction. I like to always go in on the ends and kind of smooth them out. And keeping the temperature low, but as high as possible. Even though it protects the hair up to 450, I still like to keep the temperature low just to ensure the health of her hair. Just because you have protection, guys, things can still happen. Like we said,
you still gotta use common sense.
All right, so we just got done curling Elizabeth's hair, as you can see. We haven't touched it, we haven't brushed it, we haven't fingered it, so you get to see all the definition in the curl. And remember, I didn't want to break up the curls because I want it to last a long time. You can see the ends are straighter, and that's what we want to create that beachy, undone, messy, disheveled look. My control spray is gonna help with the face framers. I love to use my control spray in these areas just to control those little flyaways. Yeah, it's the detailing. I love the hold because it's very soft, it's touchable, there's no crunch, it's dry, it's not wet. I cannot stand wet hairspray. I like it when it's dry on contact. Nobody wants to curl their hair and get it collapsed. People like body. I like to spray my Stardust Intense Shine Spray on first. Nora, can you explain why?
I love using it because it creates a really soft sheen, but it is important to spray your shine spray first because if you spray it after the hairspray, it's gonna break break your hairspray down and it won't have that hold factor anymore.
So you'll see here the definition in her curl. I'm gonna break it up. You could use your fingers to rake through it to break it up if you still want definition, but separation. But if you really want full body, you could run the brush through it and it blends furthermore. Get the My Control hairspray because you don't want anything too crunchy. You just want to control the flyaways. And now I'm gonna go in with my Power, and this is a firm hairspray. There's no flaking, there's no crunchiness, nothing like that. Oftentimes when there is like a firm hairspray, what I'm looking for is something that doesn't flake.
You remember the 80s hairspray that we used to all use? It was like lacquer.
Not only was it wet and it collapsed your hair sometimes, but as you brush through it, you get flakes and it looks like dandruff or something.
And then it also makes the hair really brittle so that when you do brush through it, it actually damages the hair.
Not with my Power hairspray, y'all. Okay, so detailing is so important. So I'll define the wave. I let the hair tell me where it wants to go. As it tells me, I use my finger to sculpt the waves. Like you see this bevel right here. I'll push that bevel up almost like it's a finger wave and miss my Power spray there to hold it. Everyone's head is different. Everyone's hair texture is different. It's the detail here that makes your finishing look so much better for your Instagram photos. I like to use a ring light. This ring light is really cool because you get to change the temperature to warm or cool. And you can see how warm lighting turns your hair almost like copper because it looks like sunset. And then we turn into white lighting, which will show the color in its purest form. So I tend to like to do white lighting more, but sometimes when dealing with copper and you're doing redheads, the white lighting actually mutes and drowns out a little bit of that warmth. So you might want to turn the warmth up just a little bit. Remember, lighting is everything. Hair changes in sunlight, window light, sunset, sunrise,
overcast.
So you see down here on the ends, it is a little bit fuzzy, right? You want to detail that out. And I like to swell the hair, fan that out right away. Use the My Power spray, spray that in place. I've been working on this product for a long time. There's a way to finish a messy look without being too messy because you still want to show off your color. There's so many outlets we're trying to reach out to our clients and you want to display your best work so you can gain more clientele in your salon.
It's versatile enough to be used backstage for hair shows, but it's also great for your clients to use every day at home as well.
So you're seeing on my phone here what it looks like. Take a look. You see how warm it looks here? But as soon as I get closer, look how the color change. It becomes cool. So it looks warm and then you tap on it, it becomes cool. Isn't that insane? And even if you bring it down and you bring it back up, it becomes warm again. I see that there's a black hole, something dark right here, so I'm gonna move the hair over. Sometimes you have to take a step back. It's the depth of perception, that's why it is. If you get too close,
it blows out.
It blows out. I'm just gonna separate right down the center here, bring it to the front, let's spin it around. We're gonna brush around her face here because we don't want things looking ropey. What I love to do is just lift the hair up and let the mist create that volume. Oh my God.
Wow.
Look at this, what?
That's all her hair. No extensions.
And I love the money piece on her. Mm-hmm. It's just enough, and she's rivaling with your money piece. She's coming after your wig, girl.
She's got her style and I have mine, but I am just drooling. It's absolutely beautiful.
Beautiful. Click thumbs up, subscribe, and
click on the bell.
Hit that bell. Leave comments, guys. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and all that stuff. And you can stalk Nora as well. Yeah?